Hello everyone, now we have to discuss the most important theorem in DC circuits, that is Thevenin's theorem. So the statement for this Thevenin's theorem is, any two terminal bilateral linear DC circuit, any two terminal bilateral DC circuit means what? For example, the examiner wants to know the value of the current through this branch, for example. So the what is the value of current through R4? Means which is present between two terminals, no? For example, this is terminal A, this is terminal B, or the examiner wants the current through this branch. In that case, this is terminal 1 and terminal 2. So, at any case, we are getting two terminals. So, that is the meaning. So, any two terminal bilateral DC circuit can be replaced by an equivalent circuit which consists of a voltage source and a series resistance with the circuit. So, the means what? This circuit can be replaced with an equivalent circuit of voltage source in series with the resistance. Okay? So, for the statement I am going to get the circuit, that is the circuit consists of a voltage source and a series resistance with the circuit. A voltage source is there and a series resistance. Okay. So, this is nothing but this is VTH, this is RTH. We will discuss what is VTH, what is RTH, okay. But this is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. This is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So, what is Thevenin's equivalent circuit? A simple voltage source is connected in series with the Thevenin's resistance, that is nothing but Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Means what? We have to reduce this circuit into this form, that is the meaning. So, whatever may be the circuit, that circuit could be replaced with this circuit. Means what? Means what? We have to get the current through this circuit. For example, the examiner wants to know the value of the current through this branch. No, for us this is load resistance, or if he wants the current through this branch, for us this is load for us, or if he wants the current through this branch, for us this is load resistance. So, it should be a resistance, it should be a voltage source, or it should be a current source. Okay, it should be a any element. He wants power loss through a voltage source. He wants power loss through a current source. He wants a power loss through a voltage source. Sorry, this resistance branch. So, for us this is low resistance. If it in the case of this branch, for us this is the low resistance. Okay? So, we have to discuss the stepwise procedure to solve the problem. Okay? This is the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. For example, the examiner wants to know the value of current through this branch. For us, this is low resistance, no? So, at last case, that is step 4, we have to connect that resistance, we can call it as low resistance, and we have to calculate the current through this load. But voltage source in series with RTH is nothing but Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay? Now, we have to discuss the stepwise procedure to calculate the problem. For example, the examiner provides this problem. To calculate the current through this branch, for example, I. So, means what? For us, this branch is load resistance for us. So, remove the load resistance, that is R4. We can call it as RL, which is equals to R4. Across the load terminals A and B. Okay. Find the open circuit voltage or Thevenin's voltage across this load resistance terminals. So, This is the given circuit. So given voltage source is like this, and we have one resistance. Again, we have another resistance. It's better to write. This is terminal A. This is terminal B. So remove the load resistance. He wants the current through this branch. That's why this is load resistance for us. So we have to, in step one, we have to remove this branch. We have to remove this branch. That's why I am removing this branch. This is what? R1, R2, R3. This is voltage source. And find the open circuit voltage, because after removing this, it should be what? In which form? Open circuited terminals. Find the open circuit voltage. Find the open circuit voltage between these two terminals, or we can call it as Thevenin's voltage, because the theorem is itself Thevenin's theorem. No, that's why open circuit voltage or Thevenin's voltage, VTH, across this open circuited terminals. Always we have to find the voltage between two open circuited terminals. Okay, so for this we have to calculate the VTH or VOC, which is equals to what? So there is a current through this branch. That current can be split into this branch, but these two terminals are in open circuited condition. Therefore, there is no current through this branch. We all know that. So simple. This voltage is nothing but what? The voltage across R3, because there is no branch here, no? Because there is no current through this R2 branch. So whatever may be the voltage, that is VOC, should be equals to what? Voltage across these two terminals, means the voltage across R3, means what? I into R3, the current from this circuit into multiplication of this R3. IR3, no, which is nothing but VTH. That is the current in the circuit, which is multiplied by R3. Okay, that is VTH. What is the value of I, which is equals to VTH, is equals to what? Total voltage by, because there is no branch here, simple loop, no, V by R1 plus R3 is nothing but current. That is V by R1 plus R3, which is multiplied by R3. This is nothing but Thevenin's voltage, means what? Voltage division principle. Total voltage into voltage across this present branch by total resistance. So like this we have to calculate VTH. Over. So finally, we have to get this equivalent circuit, no? So from this step one, we got VTH. This part is over. This part is completed. Okay. Next, step two: deactivate the voltage or current sources with their internal resistances and calculate the equivalent resistance. Equivalent resistance, but here we can call it as RTH, because Thevenin's theorem itself. That is RTH. We have to calculate RTH by looking between these two open circuited terminals. Okay. So deactivate the voltage source or current source with their internal resistances. Then the circuit becomes, here we have only one voltage source, no? So we have to replace it with what? Short circuited. Short circuited, and we have one resistance. By looking between these two, we have to calculate RTH. So this is R1, this is R2, this is R3. So by looking at these two terminals, these two are connected in parallel, and the whole combination is connected in series with what? R2. So RTH is nothing but what? Which is equals to R1 is parallel with R3, and the whole combination is connected in series with R2. So, this is RTH. So, from step 1 we got VTH, from step 2 we got RTH. So, over, the problem is over. We got this equivalent circuit, no? Simply, what is the value of VTH? That value should be appeared here. What is the value of RTH? That value should be appeared here. So, we have Thevenin's equivalent circuit, but we have the current through this branch. We have to calculate the current through this branch. So, what is step 3? Obtain equivalent circuit by placing VTH and RTH in series. We have VTH, we have RTH, and obtain that equivalent circuit. That is VTH in series with RTH. This is VTH or VOC or VOC. This is RTH. Step 3 is over. This is equivalent Thevenin circuit. Next, reconnect RL across load terminals and calculate load current. So, we have to remove this R4 in step 1, right? So, at last we have to reconnect this R4 across these two terminals and calculate the load current, okay? That is plus minus, the same circuit can be appear here. So, this is RTH, this is VTH, and we have to reconnect R4, that is nothing but RL for us, which is equals to R4 R RL. R4 for us, that is load resistance, no? That way we can name it as RL or R4. So, calculate the load current, the current through this branch I. It look like what? Simple loop. It look like what? Simple loop. The current through this branch is nothing but, that is load current is nothing but what? Total voltage by total resistance, that is RTH plus RL. This is the value of current through this branch. So, finally, we got the current through this branch. Okay, like this we have to get the value of current through any particular branch. For example, if he wants the current through this branch, so we have to replace it with what? Open circuited condition. Finally, we have to get the voltage between these two terminals, that is VTH, and after in step 2 we have to replace it with what? Short circuited. By looking between these two terminals, we have to get the equivalent RTH. Finally, we have to get the circuit VTH RTH. At last we have to connect that R3 here. For us, R3 is nothing but low resistance in that case. So, we have to connect R3 here and calculate. In final case, we have to get the simple loop circuit we got. So, whatever may be the given circuit, calculate the current through any particular branch. So, what is the circuit we have to get? This is the circuit you have to get. This circuit should be present in your mind. Don't be afraid after seeing this circuit, okay? What is your motto? To get this circuit, okay? Simply follow this procedure. We have simple steps, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. In step 1, we have to remove that low resistance terminals and calculate the equivalent Thevenin's voltage. In step 2, calculate Thevenin's resistance, and at step 3, after obtaining VTH and RTH, we are connecting the circuit as it is by substituting VTH RTH. Finally, we have to reconnect that low resistance branch as it is and calculate the current through that load resistance. Over, the problem is over.